stop. Please. No. No.
It's your own fault, Houston. Help me get the horses. Yeah.
Enough. I've only got one bullet more. I'll use it to kill you.
Why do you want to kill me? Just look at me. I ain't got a gun. I ain't never hurt nobody.
I don't believe a word. Now that he knows what you look like, he'd be sure to turn you into the marshal.
I think you are right. Yes. He must be killed.
Listen, mister. No, please don't shoot me.
No.
Dead.
Scared to death.
Who did it?
A dirty low-down bandit.
El Diablo?
Yeah, that's the one. He killed every man on this ranch. Picked them off, one by one. And the rest of his gang ran off with the horses.
Hey, hold on a second, wait! You can't leave me here. You saved my life. You gotta take me with you.
Out into the open. And make it quick if you don't want me to blow your head off. You again.
I scared you, didn't I? Why don't you take me with you?
I'd better not. I'm traveling on business.
Good. Then I can come along as your advisor. I can tell you where to buy a bunch of good horses. Or even a farm, huh?
Hold on, young fella. I'm just looking for work.
Well, that's okay, too. We'll get a job together. Anyway, where do you reckon we'll find this work?
Canyon City.
Canyon City? Ooh.
Got a quarrel? Settle it legally. Both of you are grown men, fighting like a couple of kids. All right, you. What's going on? Well, as usual. No one says a word. What about you strangers?
I did the shooting. You see, two gentlemen were about to kill each other, and I stopped them.
That's right, we did it.
Goodwill toward men, you might say. What brings you to these parts, stranger? Well, I'm going to tell you one thing. If you're looking for a bandit they call El Diablo, you better hit the road again.
This might sound strange to you, but we're looking for work.
What kind of work?
Any kind, Sheriff. Long as we can eat off it.
I still advise you to get out. But if you decide to stay, come see me tomorrow. I'll see if there's anything I can turn up for you.
Thanks.
Pays for a round of drinks.
All right, four.
Gentlemen? Where's Blake?
I left him outside.
Senorita, encore.
Un momentito, cabrón. Who do you think you're giving orders to?
Stop that laughing!
Get out of here. All of you. Make it fast.
Carry him out.
Men make me laugh the way they're always looking at me when I dance or sing. They don't know that only you are my love.
Those men are not so stupid. I'm sure they know what's going on. Actually, I'm in front of others. Try to restrain yourself.
I forgot. I'm just a poor little saloon girl, born way on the wrong side of the tracks. And you are Victor Webb, the sheriff's son, the prize catch for all the rich little girls in the county.
Don't say that, Rosario. If everything goes all right with my plans, very soon, maybe a month, we'll be out of here together.
I trust you, Victor, dear. I wouldn't want you to cheat me, because if that should happen...
It'll never happen. My horse lost a shoe.
There's the blacksmith.
All right. Come on. I got to talk with us, too.
Must you go right away? Stay with me a little longer.
You know I think any old newcomer's interesting. Especially if they manage a pistol like that man.
Hey! Blacksmith?
Put up your hands.
Thought you could get out of a real cheap, mister, huh? Well, you got some friends here. They want to talk to you.
Do you remember that you killed our brother?
Thank you.
Stark. Come on. What's going on?
Have him put down the pistol, senor. We have no quarrel with you.
We just wanted to teach a stranger here a little lesson.
Looks like he's thrown the whole schoolhouse at him. But that's enough. Get out. Don't let me see you around town. You two really like trouble, don't you?
Thanks a lot, mister.
I'm Victor Webb. My father's the sheriff.
My name's Jeff Benson, and this is Jerry, the only survivor of the massacre at the Houston farm.
What are your plans now?
We'll find something.
Won't be simple. I don't believe you'll find any work in Canyon City after what went on today.
Huh? What do you mean?
It's a miserable little town. If a man had any sense, he wouldn't even stop here long enough for a shot of whiskey. All the horse thieves and murderers west of the Rockies have gathered here for one reason or another. Most of them have joined up with El Diablo, a Mexican outlaw who keeps his headquarters across the border.
How about the sheriff?
He only has a couple of deputies. The rest of the able-bodied men in town are too afraid of El Diablo.
And I see why. My boss and all his hands were shot to death because they just wouldn't play along with him.
Seems like a situation without hope. Is that right?
Might say that. And it'll be getting worse because the United States government is going to be shipping a large amount of gold through here on its way to Mexico. They're going to like that.
The sheriff wanted to see me. Maybe because of this situation, he can find me some work.
Uh-huh. Like a cigar?
A cup of tea, Mr. Randall? There's nothing better to help a person when he's thinking.
Yes, thank you, Pamela.
And you, Dad?
No, thanks. The situation is very serious. It's a dead-end street. El Diablo and his men are committing every crime they want to and laughing at the law.
Then you don't honestly feel that you can furnish me with men who will help me transfer my herd of beef cattle south. I'm willing to pay double. There's no more pasture land where they are now. They'll starve to death if I don't move them.
That is right while you'd be moving them. But El Diablo and his gang would go into action. You can't try to do a thing like that in secret. It's useless. I'd be willing to turn in my star if I could just find out who's giving El Diablo all his information.
Don't worry, Bill. I'll tell him about
it. Okay, but don't forget to tell him right away because those guys ain't going to keep...
Papa, the men you've called are ready.
Thank you, Pamela. Come along, Randall. You can judge for yourself. Anyway, let's hope for the best and that you can recruit all the men you need.
For me. I told Pamela to tell him to come, and she said she'd tell him, so she will.
All right, here he is now.
Hello, boys. Thanks for coming. Mr. Randall's hitting the trail with quite a few head of cattle, and he needs a lot of hands to ride herd. He's offering double wages and a generous bonus at the end of the job. Well?
You tell him, Joe. Go ahead.
We're all pretty sure what you had in mind when you had us come today. And you should be able to guess what we have to say. Ain't one of us willing to accept.
But how can you answer like that when you have no idea what I'm willing to offer?
Not even if you gave us all the gold in the world. El Diablo doesn't forget. So even if we escaped, he'd find some way of getting to us and killing us all.
I'll remind you, Joe, that there's a law in this state that obliges everybody to take up arms against bandits.
Yeah, if it's a question of defending our lives or our families, but not to defend a herd of cows.
I'm sure you realize that a herd of cows is your livelihood, Joe. Believe me, cattle can feed you, words can.
And they can bury every man of us. I'm sorry for you, Cher, and for you, Mr. Randall, but our decision is made.
What about you? What do you think of all this?
If you'll pardon us, Sheriff, we see it differently.
Pamela, put the pot on the stove. The big one.
Yes, right away, Papa.
Come in. We'll talk this over. Agreed?
Perfectly.
You'd better be leaving soon. Mr. Randall's pasture's a good 10 miles away.
At the pasture, you'll find what few of my men who are willing to stay on to protect the herd. They're good men, but I don't know how far they're willing to go against El Diablo.
That's something I wanted to talk to you about, Randall. If I should take it, I want one thing. Your men must obey my orders.
Oh, aren't you expecting a little too much? For a newcomer, anyway?
But he's also the only one who had the courage to accept Mr. Randall's deal. Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm not aiming to profit by this situation. But I have some special ideas on how to get El Diablo.
Listen to him, Sheriff. He's always got good ideas.
Very well, Mr. Benson. I accept. And oh, yes. I'll write you a note to take the list of my head wrangler, because unhappily, I can't go with you.
Hello. Still looking for trouble, eh, Benson? Seems like the lesson that your four friends gave you wasn't enough for you, was it?
I see you two know each other.
As a matter of fact, I'd really like to thank you again for what you did for me.
Oh, in Canyon City, things like that happen every day.
I've often asked Washington for federal assistance, but never got any.
Yes, I'm afraid it's up to us to defend our property ourselves against those bandits.
The
government has too many problems. The situation in Canyon City is the same as in every border town, unfortunately. Mr. Randall, which route are we going to take?
In my opinion, the ford outside Lexington would be the safest route, even though it's not the shortest.
Well, that sounds like a good idea.
The important thing is that El Diablo not know about it.
That's important, all right.
You'll find the herd about half an hour past the Sacramento turnoff. Here's the message, Benson.
You know how to get there?
Let me show him the way to the turnoff, Papa. In 2 hours, I'll be back at the house.
All right.
Thanks, Sheriff.
My father always wanted to send Victor away to school to make a lawyer out of him, but he preferred to stay at home.
Now that I've heard about your family, why don't you tell me something about you?
My story is very simple. I was born here. My mother died when I was only a child. And from that time on, all I've done is take care of my father. I've never left Canyon City. And the only new things that ever happen in my life are when someone comes from the outside.
Disappointed?
Oh, no, you're very sweet. Just a little impulsive, that's all.
What do you mean by that?
Back at the house, you didn't take your eyes off me. I was afraid Papa'd notice it.
I've never seen a girl as pretty as you anywhere.
You'll make me blush.
Oh, fine. You look even better with red cheeks.
That's enough, Jim. Look, the turnoff's over there.
Oh!
You'll have to climb the hill over there, then just a few yards further up the road, you'll find Randall's herd.
Thanks.
And now, adios, Jim.
Why adios? Hasta la vista.
Hasta la vista. All right, Jim.
Would you take a message to your father? Would you just say to him that I'll be around quite a bit? Hasta la vista. And empty bottles. Two. Well?
Buenas tardes, Diablo. Chico Gonzalez says I should tell you he has cash for all the cattle you can lay your hands on.
Sorry, amigo. You've come at a bad time.
That's too bad, because Gonzalez would take over 1,000 head.
It is a pity. I can't find 100. The rancheros are being very careful these days.
And this time, Gonzalez is willing to pay much more than the usual amount.
Madre de Dios. 1,000 head. Where do I find them?
You can have 2,000 head, Diablo.
Rosario.
Go to Gonzalez, Pedro, and say he's to bring the cash across the border, as usual. He'll have the cattle he wants. The finest herd ever seen in this county.
Senorita, El Diablo was just saying a minute ago that he did not know where to find any. Do you mean...
Do not doubt Rosario's words, you filthy swine. Anything she says, it is the same as if I said it myself.
Of course, Diablo, of course. I didn't mean...
Get out!
I'm here on business. Mr. Randall's herd is being transferred now, and in about 2 days it'll get to Lexington.
Mr. Randall, huh? This is very interesting.
But Randall's rich. He must have brought an escort.
Don't be worried. All the men in town are afraid of you. So Randall is sending along an escort of only 2 men, the only ones that would go.
This is the break we've been waiting for. That money, we can go away together.
Not yet, Diablo. There's something much more important that we've got to do first. The gold that's on its way to Mexico.
That's too big a job, Rosario. There'll be a whole division along for protection.
I'd say you're a bit frightened. But think how we'd enjoy life in Mexico with all that gold around us.
We'll talk it over when the time comes.
I must leave. I don't want anyone to notice I've been gone so long.
When will I see you?
Might be soon. Might be any day. Depends on you.
Rosario, I have friends in Canyon City. They tell me that you and Victor...
You must have faith in me, Diablo, if you don't want to lose me forever.
Rosario was right. In a few days, there will be a Lexington Ford. We can go tell Diablo.
They're getting closer. They are in our trap now.
Thank you. I'm sorry for all the dust you had to swallow. Come on, let's get back to the herd.
Papa? You with a drink in your hand?
I'm making an exception today, Pamela. It's such a long time since I had any good news.
Your father has every right to celebrate, my dear Pamela. Just think, Jeff Benson was able to move my entire herd safely without the loss of a single beast or a single man.
I was certainly wrong in judging that fellow Jeff. I find it very hard to believe that a work hand like that could have such smart ideas all the time. Which leads me to believe he's hiding something from us.
And I saw immediately that he was different from all the other men.
Yes, I can see he's impressed you. I wonder where our wandering hero is now.
He said he would ride along with the herd for another couple of days at least, and then make his way back to my ranch.
If I were in his shoes, I'd be heading for some other place. El Diablo's not a forgiven man, and I'd say he doesn't think much of Jeff or his friends.
I don't understand what makes you talk like that. Anybody'd think you didn't like the man.
Well, I don't know. I did save his life the other day.
I guess I'll be needing Jeff's help again pretty soon, Randall.
For the gold that's coming through, eh?
Yes. It could come any day now, and I don't know how I'm going to guarantee delivery to the Mexicans. I've tried to recruit men here in the city. I promised them all a big bonus, but I got the usual answer. No.
It's almost unbelievable. I just hope the success of the cattle transfer will give this town some encouragement to stand up to those bandits.
I'm glad you came back undercover, Jeff. There's trouble around for you.
I know. The vengeance of El Diablo.
You're so calm about it. Oh, Jeff, don't take it so lightly. Don't worry me so.
Your words tell me that I wasn't wrong.
I don't understand.
Well, I felt that my attention wasn't wasted on you.
I'm terribly sorry the bandits are after you. You were very brave. My father really likes you very much.
Never mind your father. Just tell me one thing. Was I wrong? Where was I?
I knew there was something about you, Jeff. I knew it the minute you walked in.
I burn up the road to get here to see you.
And now leave. And be careful. El Diablo has his spies everywhere. And you're the one that they're looking for.
I'm leaving when Diablo's dead. And all his filthy bandits are dead, too. I'm sticking with this till it's over.
But I can't stand it to think of you always in trouble.
I promise you, I'll stay away from Canyon City. At least in the daytime. But tomorrow night at 9, I'll come back. Try to be free.
Mm-hmm.
I'll wait for you.
Pamela.
That's my father calling. Good night, Jeff.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Who's there?
something's gone right ever since I first saw that cowboy. He fooled us all with that business on the cattle. I don't want him to do the same thing with the gold.
I've told you, El Diablo doesn't want any part of that.
And I tell you, we can't do it without him. It's up to you to convince him.
But do you know what he wants from me? Just the sight of that man fills me with disgust.
You were the masters of promising everything, giving nothing.
You speak of me like you speak of a thing. An object that serves some use.
My dear, everything I'm doing for you. So that someday both of us can escape from this hellhole we're living in and be rich and happy in San Francisco or Los Angeles or some other big city. With you by my side. I'll buy you dresses. I'll buy you everything. I'll buy you my gold.
Every time I meet El Diablo's men, I make them run like frightened rabbits. I got a punch like a mule and an eye like an eagle. All I gotta do is blink and they run.
Well, amigo, blink and make me run.
Good afternoon, amigos. Does your little party have room for one more? Jerry, I just can't leave you alone for 1 minute. It's dangerous to play around with pistols. Jerry, get their guns.
One, two, three, four, five.
Now we can have fun together. Say it's Jeff Benson?
Yeah, Jeff Benson.
And he's the one I have to blame for the failure with Randall's herd.
See, he's the one, all right. The one who blocks every move we make.
When I think I had him in my hands.
Why didn't you kill him?
I would have, Diablo, but I was stopped. The sheriff protects him.
The sheriff. The sheriff! But El Diablo's not afraid of the sheriff. Where is he now, this Jeff Benson?
He was in Canyon City earlier, but Barro saw him go. But tomorrow night he's going into town again. And I know where he's going.
Jeff?
were the fastest gun I ever saw and the strongest puncher, too, but I didn't know you were a magician. How did you manage to find out that El Diablo was going to take his men out of their hideout tonight?
And that's not all. I can also tell you where he's going.
Where?
To Canyon City. To kill you and me.
Huh?
We just have to wait till it gets dark. And it will.
Papa, I'm going to sleep now. I'm tired.
All right, Pamela. I'm staying up. I can't go to sleep until a certain telegram comes in. Good night.
Good night.
Jeff Benson out with his hands up. I know he's in there. You won't help yourself by protecting him. Send him out.
You're mistaken, Diablo. There's no one here.
Is that so? Then ask your daughter where she hid him.
It's true, Papa. Jeff was supposed to get here at 9, but he didn't come. I swear it.
All right, Sheriff. You've got no choice. I'll burn down your house and the whole town if you don't come out with Benson in front of you. Damn you! You'll pay for that!
All right, stop. I'm coming out.
Tell that coyote Benson to come out, too, so I can kill him.
He's not here, I told you. You're welcome to search the house if you want to.
Don't try to fool me.
Hold on, Diablo. My father's telling the truth.
Sheriff, if you need me, just send for me.
You look worried about something. The gold will be traveling to Mexico by railway and passing through here day after tomorrow. I've been ordered to prepare an adequate escort. How am I going to find an adequate escort in this miserable little prairie town where every man is scared out of his wits? And after what happened this evening?
Strange, Papa. El Diablo tonight could have killed us. Instead, he rode off with his men and didn't do any harm to anyone.
I know. But what would he have gained by killing us? We aren't the ones he's after. He just fired some shots to scare the people a little more.
Or else, he was afraid of me. Don't worry.
Troveremo qualcuno che farà da scorta a loro.
Cosa c'è ancora?
Jeff!
Meno male che siete arrivati solo ora, perché qualcuno vi cercava. Però, se quel bandito viene a sapere che siete qui, potrebbe tornare. Stavolta non avreste via di scampo.
Credo che abbia ben altro da fare.
Chissà la faccia che farà quando scoprirà che gli abbiamo fatto saltare la tana.
Ma come siete penetrati?
Sì, nel covo di El Diablo. Decisamente la vita a voi due pesa. E non so se la prossima volta che vi troverete nei guai potrò fare qualcosa per voi. Beh, io me ne vado. Chissà che non possa trovare qualcuno che ti dia una mano, papà. Ci vediamo più tardi. Buonanotte.
Jeff, mio padre sa di noi due.
Avrei preferito dirvelo io stesso, Webb, quando le cose qui a Canyon City si fossero placate.
Le cose a Canyon City non si placeranno mai.
Pamela, scusa, vorrei restare solo con tuo padre.
Venite, Jerry, vi farò assaggiare delle ciambelle squisite.
Lo avete ricevuto questa sera?
Sì.
E parla dell'oro in arrivo?
Mi sbalordite. Come fate a sapere di che si tratta? Agente federale Jeff Benson?
Sì, ma non lo direte a nessuno. Nemmeno a Pamela e nemmeno a vostro figlio Francisco. La mia missione è segreta. L'oro deve passare la frontiera.
Domattina ci metteremo in contatto con Forte Lincoln, perché l'oro parte di là.
Nothing? Keep on trying.
It's no use. No one answers.
Someone must have cut the wires.
We have no time to waste, Bill. We've got to get them working again.
That's not so easy. You don't even know where the wires were cut.
Go call Tim and tell him to get over here with his gear. He'll ride out with Jeff and Jerry. We'll wait here.
All right.
Yours.
Don't worry, nothing to it.
You bow through?
Just one more minute, Jeff. I want Fort Lincoln.
Yep.
Thank you.
Bravo, Blake. I knew this little trick would work. Get behind them.
You three, come with me.
My part of the job is over, Diavolo. Now it's your turn.
But this is the stupid one. Where's the other?
Don't worry. I've taken care of Benson for good. I'm on my way back to Canyon City. And don't forget, Rosario is waiting for you at the camp.
Ah! Miguel! Keep an eye on him.
Don't worry, I will.
Thank you.
luce. Oh, vida mia, tu mi scriverò, si lo haces por reproche, oh, jealousia. La luna, la brisa, el mar, me basta para soñar que siempre tú quedarás
. Now I'm going to stay with you all my life, Diablo.
What did you say?
That now I'm yours.
Querida.
But you must earn me first, Diablo.
Si, mi amor.
The gold from Mexico is about to arrive, and we must have it.
That gold again. I've told you I want no part of it.
Poor Diablo, you don't frighten anyone anymore. You're a beaten man. They even came into your hideout and destroyed it.
I'll get back everything and take vengeance.
With what? With the money you get attacking ranches and stagecoaches? Those too big for you too, Diablo. After this, no more jobs. With so much money, the world is ours. Everything will be yours and mine. We'll go anywhere, do anything.
Was it Victor who spoke to you?
Yes, but of what importance is he? I've told you I've come here to stay. Victor was useful because of the information he sent. We'll give him his share, and we'll never see him again.
Can I believe this?
If you don't, I'll give you proof of it. Tomorrow, when you attack the train, I'll be fighting at your side.
No, Rosario. I would never let you. Your love is too precious for me to risk losing it.
El Diablo's gang, the same one that cut the lines. Did you contact Fort Lincoln?
Yes, the train will be passing through our territory very early in the morning.
All right.
Volunteer, Victor.
I told you I could find somebody.
How's everything, Jeff?
Everything's all right, Sheriff. We're ready for whatever happens.
Good.
We're coming into Canyon City territory.
First damn town on the frontier.
Come on, let's put on some steam like we're supposed
Casey, what's happening?
Come on, get up, you old drunkard.
Well, Sheriff, here we are. Some of this, Diablo. You weren't expecting 30 Winchesters to welcome you, huh?
Now's the time to unhook the car.
Finished, Chief. Just old Stark found a bullet.
Shame. Now I guess we can say goodbye to you, too.
Oh, come on. You don't mean it.
Thank you.
I warned you, my darling. I warned you.
What about the girls, Jeff? I bet they're crazy about federal agents.
Jeff! You just going without a word?
Your brother's death has separated us, Pamela. If it weren't for me...
It would have worked out just the same. Victor had to pay someday for going against the law. You just did your duty. I know that, and so does Father. Stay, Jeff. If my love means anything to you.
Take this as a command post. I'm going to be in Canyon City from now on.
Yoo-hoo! Hey-ya!